Hello everyone. So in this tutorial, we are going to teach you on how to install WordPress on VestaCP. Start by going to the Vesta control panel and insert your username and your password. Click login. So after login, in the administrator, you can change the password by generating a new one. After that, go to the web domain, and as you can see, there is no SSL support. To get it, you press the edit button. In the alias box, just leave it blank. If you have not the subdomain, if the full domain, then put the www and something. Write the SSL support and also tick the Let's Encrypt support. This is the free SSL that provided by the administrator. But the certificate only valid for the 3 months. And after 3 months, it will generate a new one. If you want the app web statistic to monitor your website, click the AWS tab and click save. Okay, as you can see, the change has been saved successful, but the certificate is still blank because you need to refresh the page. Just go back and press edit, and if you click to the page, you can see the certificate and scroll down to see the expired date, which is only last longer for 3 months. You can try by typing HTTPS in your domain, and you can see that your connection is not secure because you have received the free certificate, SSL certificate. Back to the Vesta control panel, go to the database and you can create a new user. So this is the database name, whatever name you want. And then click add, and the database is already success. So now we are going to install the WordPress into the VestaCP. The first step you need to do is to download the FTP software, which is called the FileZilla. FileZilla is an open source software. So download the FileZilla 64 bits, click the free version. So whatever you want to upload, you are going to need this FileZilla client. So install the FileZilla and wait for the loading data. Choose the default setting and just click next. So after that, start the FileZilla. So this is the FileZilla. Connect your domain by putting the domain on the host and put your Vesta username and the password, and then press quick connect and click OK, and then it will connect to the server and your website file will be available at the public HTML. Whatever file you want to upload about the website is going to upload the file public HTML folder. So let's say if you will try to delete it, it will become like this. See, there is no, this is the default looks. So now we are going to the WordPress org. We are going to download the WordPress, click the get WordPress and download the WordPress. Wait for the WordPress download to finish. Go to the download folder. So then extract the file and then you can open the WordPress file. Go to the FileZilla back and make sure that your public HTML show that your domain. Head over to your WordPress file and highlight all. And then right click upload. So what it's going to do is going to upload all your file into the public HTML. So after you already transfer finish, it will show the notification of successfully transfer. And then go to your domain. As you can see, it's already up. And then you can select your language based on your admin area. Then click continue. And then they will ask to your database name and username and password. Just click let's go. For the database name, copy from your Vesta. Username, also put the same. And the password is using the old password that you copied before. And then click submit. And then it will detect your server and run the installation. The site title will be the general name that you can edit later in your WordPress. So for now, you can put anything. And also the username. So this is the password. For the email, you can use your email. If you still want to construct your website, you can click this. If your website is ready to launch, just leave it and then click install WordPress. And then it will be success. And now you can log into your WordPress. So this is like a domain which log in WordPress. So if you're going to your domain, you can see the front end of your website. And you can now try to log in to your WordPress. Put your username and password and then click login. Just to make clear that you need to make sure your Q file and there is no fail transfer from your file Zilla to your public HTML file. If not, your website is not going to up and your WordPress is not going to working. So that's all for this tutorial. If you have any question, you can comment down below or head over to our website, vestacp.com, and go for the live chat session. Thank you.